My name is Karolina, and I'm from Poland. I am married to a Hindu man. For many across the world, the 9 days of Navratri are dedicated to celebrating the divine feminine. And in our home, these celebrations bring a lot of happiness. So this is the first time that we are in my Polish home during Navratri days. This is also the first time my family in Poland is able to experience these celebrations with us. As you can see, we are already dressed up in traditional Indian clothes, and I am making the traditional dishes like halwa, puri and chana.
Lubisz halwę? Spróbujesz potem, jak mamusia zrobi?
Tak.
Halwa jest pyszna, tak?
Tak.
Once this is done, we are going to attend a small puja session. By the way, my father is waiting downstairs for us, and he has never seen me in a saree in Poland. So this is going to be a bit of a surprise for him.
Cześć, tato.
Witajcie.
Jak no. Godzina wygląda?
Ślicznie. A, przepięknie.
Przepięknie wygląda?
Super.
I co myślisz o indyjskim saree?
Coś piękniejszego nie może być na świecie.
Naprawdę?
Naprawdę.
Widzisz, dziadziowi się
przepiękne.
Podoba? Dziadziowi się bardzo podoba, tak? Może kupimy dziadziowi taki indyjski strój dla dziadzia. Tak?
Może być.
To przywieziemy dziadziowi następnym razem, dobra?
No, no.
In Anurag's family, the Navratri food is shared and eaten together with the kids from the neighborhood. Since we are in Poland this Navratri, we are planning to drive to my sister and share the food with her kids. Anyway, there is something more that I would like to talk about. Sometimes I get disappointed by how in India, on many occasions, beautiful festivals end up bringing some kind of controversy. According to the media reports, an ad campaign by Eros Now featured stills from Bollywood movies with captions that were slammed as distasteful by many on social media. Later it was reported that the company issued an apology. These kind of situations make me think, why is it challenging for companies that have so many resources to simply share their festival greetings in a non-controversial way? Well, if you don't want to wish others in their festivals, that's your choice. But why share posts that can offend or hurt people? When I explained the meaning of the Navratri celebrations to my friends and family in Poland, they were so impressed by the beautiful meaning of these ancient Indian traditions. They were very surprised that in India there is such an old tradition of worshipping Shakti. Not all cultures have a tradition that celebrates the divine feminine this way. In Europe, my friends usually tell me that they have never heard of this side of the Indian culture before.